Hello, dear Steemians, YouTubers, members of Uptrend, and all beautiful and creative blockchain people. That's me again at CryptoSpa, and this is my next cryptocurrency market overview. So let's start. Let's have a look at the prices of the major cryptocurrencies according to the beautiful site of CoinGecko. And we see that the prices of most of the major cryptocurrencies have stabilized for the last few days, and they've been trading sideways. For example, price of Bitcoin has been hovering near the psychological level of $8,000 per one digital coin for the last almost 6 or 7 days. And this, the same dynamic has been followed by Ethereum, by Bitcoin Cash, Litecoin, EOS, and etc. That's why today I won't comment on any particular price chart of any cryptocurrency, and I just want to mention some interesting news relating to the cryptocurrency world. The first thing that I want to mention today is that Binance, or one, we know that this is one of the biggest crypto exchanges in the world, they published yesterday, and actually they published few announcements before that, that Binance futures, or the platform of Binance for futures, is going to launch a product actually with maximum leverage to 125x, and it launches leverage adjustment function. So yes, the traders, or actually I will call it the gamblers, I will reiterate the word, the gamblers, will be able to buy crypto and sell crypto with this insane massive leverage. And I just want to say that in my view, this is not something good, and let me tell you why. Because I've been working on the financial markets for the last 13 years, and I have been using very often leverage. And let's say 10 or 12 years ago, I used a lot of leverage. And I know that 125, this is something ridiculous actually, and this is not trading, it's going to be gambling. And also, I used to be a lecturer, and for almost 3 years, and I conducted many courses, and I told many people what leverage is, what the financial markets are, what kind of assets we have, what kind of trading platforms we have, what kind of leverage is the appropriate for the different traders. And I have and I told people that a very high leverage is very dangerous, and at the end of the day, it will destroy the money or the deposits of those traders that use very high leverage. And I want to say I'm very familiar with this. And once again, I was a lecturer for 3 years. For 3 years, I used to explain to people how it works. And that's why I know that this is something really ridiculous. In my view, it's going to be some kind of gamble or casino. It's not trading. And Bitcoin is so volatile that using 125x leverage to trade Bitcoin is something really insane. Because if you use such kind of leverage even for fiat money, as US dollar, euro, Japanese yen, that are quite stable relative to the Bitcoin at the moment, I think I want to say the daily volatility is incomparable. And that's why I want to say that this is something I don't like. I think that in the long run, it may damage the image of Binance. Binance is nowadays considered to be one of the leading exchanges in the world. In the long run, if they really emphasize on such kind of products, it will change their image from a major cryptocurrency into major gambling platform for gamblers. And I'm not very happy when I see such kind of products. Also, I want to say that many media outlets commented on this. Some of them think that this is something good. Some of them think that this is something not that good. It's up to you. I just share my point of view. And since I already opened the site of Cointelegraph, I want to say that I read today earlier some other news on the site of Cointelegraph, and this is actually the news that Fidelity Investments fully rolls out crypto custody service, executive says. So we know that Fidelity Investment is, let's say, some kind of fund or vehicle for institutional investors to buy crypto, and they are going to develop ETFs, exchange traded funds. And I want to say that I saw that many people in the cryptocurrency world today, they commented and yesterday on this news, if it is beneficial to have ETFs run by Fidelity in the cryptocurrency world. I mean ETFs on Bitcoin. So I have commented many times on such kind of news, and I want to say that in my view, it's not something really positive. Yes, it may be to some extent neutral, or it may have at the very beginning some slight positive signal. For example, it is a signal showing that the infrastructure of Bitcoin and the cryptocurrency world is developing. Many more products, new products are appearing, coming to this cryptocurrency world. But I don't think that it may trigger some kind of bull run, such kind of, let's say, news. Because, for example, now I will show you some theory applicable to the ecosystem of Bitcoin. And that's why I want to say that I'm not very positive about such kind of news, that big players will run exchange traded funds or some kind of derivatives on Bitcoin. Let me explain you why. For example, this is the Metcalfe's law that is applicable to any industry from the network economy. And in my view, the cryptocurrency world is a classic example of network economy. So this is, in my view, what network economy is. The cryptocurrency world. That's why some laws applicable to the network economy, and actually the idea or the theory of the network effects of within this network economy, in my view, are very applicable. These theories are very applicable to the Bitcoin ecosystem. So it means the value, or let's say in brackets, the price of the ecosystem of Bitcoin, so the value of Bitcoin, or in brackets, the price of the ecosystem of Bitcoin depends on the number of interactions between the participants in this ecosystem, according to the Metcalfe's law that is applicable to the network economy. And what I want to say is that the more people we have, or the users we have in the ecosystem of Bitcoin, and the more often they use this cryptocurrency as a medium of exchange, so it means the more transactions we have, the higher the value of this ecosystem is. So we need more users and more interactions between the users. Now, let's analyze what would happen if we were, if there were many, let's say, big institutional investors or ETFs, for example. It means that this is, for example, how the network economy is illustrated, how the network economy is illustrated to work. We have funds, so let's say this is the participants in the network of some kind of assets, and this is the number of interactions between them. Let's assume that we have some kind of ETFs, big players come to the market. Then we can just remove part of those funds, because ETFs, they will buy Bitcoins and they will block these Bitcoins, and these Bitcoins won't be used for any transactions. So yes, theoretically they are still in the Bitcoin ecosystems, those Bitcoins bought by the ETFs, but actually they are out of circulation because they will be blocked and they won't be used within the ecosystem of Bitcoin for transactions. Because ETFs, these are paper derivatives on these blocked assets and on this underlying assets, in our case on Bitcoin. And it means that we will reduce the number of phones, so in our case the number of Bitcoins in circulation and the number of transactions. Yes, I know, 2 years ago I had some kind of debate with one cryptocurrency enthusiast that said that no, you are not right, even if there are many ETFs and institutional investors in the ecosystem of Bitcoins and they don't use these Bitcoins, they just hodl them somewhere. Even if we have in this case just one Bitcoin, it is enough to be, let's say, split into many Satoshis, and people may use just these Satoshis to transact with each other. Yes, theoretically, it is true, but this is just theoretically. And practically, in practice, I think that if we reduce the number of participants, so the number of Bitcoins, and if we reduce the number of transactions between the members of the ecosystem because of these big players that will block these Bitcoins, it will reduce the number of transactions and the value at the end of the day, the value of the ecosystem. That's why I think that such kind of ETFs in the long run, if they become too many, it will damage the ecosystem of Bitcoin. And that's why I'm not very positive about such kind of news. Bitcoin is the money for the for us, for the people. It's not for the big players. The main idea when Bitcoin was launched is to be able this decentralized payment system to compete with these big players, to destroy, to dismantle these big players and to return the money into the hands of the people. And now I don't understand why people are happy when they see such kind of news that big players from their fiat centralized ecosystem are coming to the decentralized ecosystem in order to centralize. I don't understand this logic why people are so happy about it. But anyway, this is my point of view. I may not be right. It's up to you. Of course, if you have another point of view, just share your view under this video and I will glad to discuss it with you. That's it for today, fellas. Thank you for watching. I wish you a wonderful day and hope to see you in my next video. It was me at CryptoSpa.